Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear students, welcome to our class. We are now learning chapter 22. In the last class, we saw about the blood pressure, pulse rate, heart. Mainly we saw about heart and how the transportation happens in human beings. Okay, before that we saw transportation in plants. Okay, so inshallah, this class we will see about the circulatory medium. Okay, in our body we have the circulatory system, and there are some fluids which are there in the circulatory system. We will see about it, and hope you studied well in the last class. Okay, now we will see the circulatory medium. So our body has three different types of fluids. Okay, the first one is it's blood is the first one, and this is the first one, blood, and you have, it is found in heart and blood vessels, okay, like arteries, veins and capillaries, which we saw while we saw about the heart. Okay, and the second one is the tissue fluid. Okay, this is the second one, and the third one is that lymph. Okay, the tissue fluid, it's found in spaces between cells in organs. Okay, we have cells in our organs, and there are spaces in between the cells, so they, some fluids are present, they are called as tissue fluid. And the blood, it is found in heart and blood vessels. Blood vessels are arteries, veins and capillaries. And the third fluid that is present in our body is lymph fluid. Okay, this is the third one. It is found in lymph vessels. Okay, vessels means the tubes. Okay, so it is found in lymph vessels and lymphatic organs. There are some organs which produce this lymph fluid, so they are called as lymphatic organs. For example, spleen and tonsils. You can Google up and you can see the images where spleen and tonsils are present. Tonsil present near our throat. Okay, and then we will now see about blood, inshallah. So it's a connective tissue. Blood is basically a connective tissue. You have to remember this word. Blood is a connective tissue that circulates throughout the body, and it is made up of a fluid medium. Okay, it's called plasma. Okay, you have to remember, blood is made up of a fluid medium called as plasma, and there are two types of blood cells are present in the blood, in the plasma. The first one is that red blood cells. Okay, the first one is red blood cells, and the second one is white blood cells. Okay, this is the second type of blood cell that is present in the blood. So when you say blood, you have to remember it's made up of, it's a connective tissue that circulates throughout the body. Okay, it connects a tissues and all the nutrients and proteins and whatever other liquids that are necessary, okay, that are processed through the blood. That's why it is called as, it's a connective tissue, and it contains a fluid medium. It contains a fluid medium called as plasma, and in that there are two types of blood cells. One is red blood cells, and the one is white blood cells. And also it has some cell fragments called as blood platelets. Okay, blood platelets are present, and blood platelets, they are mainly used in for blood clotting. So if there is a bleeding happens in our body, it gets clotted. Okay, it does not completely, it is not like continuously flowing. Okay, it becomes dried up. That's what is called as clotting. It's because of this blood platelets which is present in the blood, that you have to remember. And where it is produced, blood cells, where it is produced in the bone marrow. Okay, bone marrow, what is bone marrow? We have in our body, we have bones, right? Like, let's say like this, any random, and inside it, there will be bone marrow present in it. If you have eaten mutton, okay, or beef or anything, and while biting the bones, inside you will see a black color thing. That's what is called as bone marrow. That is a place where the blood cells are manufactured, that you have to remember. And these are the types of blood cells. First one is you have red blood cell, and then you have majorly white blood cell, and then you have platelets. Okay, we will see one by one red blood cell and white blood cell, their properties and their functions. And then you have basophil, you have eosinophil, neutrophil, monocyte, and lymphocyte. These 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these they are types of white blood cell. Okay, they are subtypes of white blood cell. They all have different functions which we are not going to see now, which is not necessary for you students to learn now. You just remember the names and you learn how to draw this. Okay, this will be, this you have to draw in your examination. If they ask like write about different types of blood cells, then you have to write about red blood cells and white blood cells, and you have to draw these cells. Okay, it's very easy, inshallah. Just practice drawing these cells. Okay, now we will see the properties and functions of red blood cells. Red blood cells are also called as erythrocytes. Okay, and they are circular in shape. Their shape, they look circular, and they have a red colored pigment called as hemoglobin, which we already discussed, which we have discussed before. It has a red color pigment which is called as hemoglobin, and there is no nucleus present in RBC, that you have to remember. Okay, there is no nucleus present in red blood cells, and the function of RBC is that it carries oxygen to tissues and bring back carbon dioxide from tissues. Okay, so it carries oxygen. Okay, in the heart, the oxygen, it is taken to the tissues where the oxygenated blood is utilized, and from there the carbon dioxide is brought back and we exhale it. And the second one is white blood cells. It's also called as leukocytes. Okay, their short form, you can see red blood cells are called as RBC and white blood cells are called as WBC. Okay, since they carry no pigments, in red blood cells you have hemoglobin, which is a red color pigment, so it looks red in color. But white blood cells, they don't have any pigments, so they are colorless, that you have to remember. And it's not like RBC. Okay, it's irregular in shape. There's no specific shape like circular or other shape. It is irregular in shape. And what is the function of white blood cells? They prevent the body from infections. Okay, so they eat up the germs. These cells, they eat up the germs, or by producing antibodies. Okay, antibodies. Antibodies is a type of immune cells that kill the germs and bacteria that are present in our body. So if I say antibody, you have to remember that they are like a security guard. Okay, let's say security guard or police. Okay, you have to remember, just for your understanding, I'm using this word security guard. Like how you have in places security guard, if someone enters, they check, if they are dangerous, what do they do? They shoot. Okay, like that, antibodies are immune cells. They protect our body, that you have to remember. And antigens are like anything that comes, that's foreign to our body. Okay, anything that is foreign to our body, like a stranger. This is the difference between antibodies and antigens. Don't confuse yourself. When you say antibodies, it's like a bodyguard word. You remember with this word, okay? Antigens, like a stranger. Okay, stranger foreign particle to our body. Okay, so if there are any germs or bacteria, then they are antigens. Then antibodies, they fight against this antigens and kill it. That's how our body immune system works. The next is about blood platelets. They are also called as thrombocytes. Another name. They are very small fragments of cells. You can see here. Okay. They are very small fragments of cells, and they don't have any nuclei. Okay. That you have to remember. And as I told before, their main function is clotting of blood. When there is a blood flow in our body, when we have any injury, you know, and some wound happens, injury happens, then blood flow happens, and after some time the blood flow stops. It is because of the clotting of blood. The blood gets dried up. Okay, that's why if there are less blood plates present in someone's blood, then that leads to continuous flow of blood. Then doctors might have to give some medicine to control the blood flow if there is any injury. Okay, what is the function of blood? As I told, blood carries nutrients. They carry oxygen from heart to other tissues. They carry carbon dioxide from tissues. Okay, and the hormones. There are some hormones like some chemical substances which are needed for some functions or process in our body, and they carry that, and also they carry waste material to the relevant parts of the body. After the processing, when there are waste material like bacteria or germs or other waste material, then they are also transported through the blood. These are the main function. Okay, and also some medicines we take, right, like injection or other medicines. So when taken in the body, they are also distributed through the blood. That you have to remember. And now we'll see about blood groups and blood transfusion. You must have heard that in hospitals they announce that they need blood. So they ask for your blood group, whether you are A positive or B positive or A negative, like that. Different blood groups are there. You must have heard. Okay. So how do they categorize these blood groups? That's what we are going to see now, inshallah. So they are the different blood group types, or because of the different types of proteins that are present in the blood. Okay, that's how they categorize the blood group. So injecting blood into the body from outside is called as blood transfusion. Okay, so if they inject blood from outside, then that process is called as blood transfusion. It is successful only when the blood of the donor is the one who is giving the one who is donating the blood. Okay, that is the when the blood of the donor is matches with the blood of the recipient, one who receives the blood. So you have to remember these two words. One is donor, that is the one who gives the blood, and recipient is the one who receives the blood. So both of their blood should match. Okay, then only the blood transfusion will be successful. Otherwise, if there is unmatch, then what happens? Agglutination happens. Agglutination is nothing but the clumping together because of different blood groups, and then it will affect the blood flow, and the recipient may even die. So as I told, the blood group, they are classified based on the types of protein that is present in the blood. So this system of this classification, in which bloods are classified based on the different types of protein present in the blood, it is called as ABO system. Okay, ABO system. and there are four types of blood groups, AB and O. Okay, and there are antigens present on the member of RBC. We know that RBC is a red blood cell, and there is an antigen, okay, antigen which is present on the membrane of the RBC, which is counteracted by antibodies present in the plasma of recipient. Let's say that you have one blood group here, okay, this is one type of blood cell and another type of blood cell, different person and different blood group, okay. This is the RBC, let's say, and there are antigens that are present on the membrane of the RBC, okay, and also they will have antibodies as well. For let's say that here there is an antibody like a God. So now when this blood goes and joins with this, okay, this antibody should not fight this antigen, then only these two will be accepted, then they will be successful in the blood transfusion. So if there is a mismatch, then what happens, the blood transfusion won't be successful. There are some blood groups can be given to another blood group person, okay, it is all due to the antigens and antibodies present in the blood, okay. So for example, if you take blood group A, then the antigen present on RBC is that A, okay, blood group A, it has RBC A antigen present on the RBC, and it has antibody present in the plasma for the B, okay. So what happens if A has antibody against B, okay, what happens, then the B blood group, when it comes, then it will attack. So B cannot be given to the A blood group. That's why here they have given A can be given to A and AB, but it cannot be given to B blood group. And also A blood group, they can receive blood from A and O. Why they can receive blood from O, we will see here inshallah. So as for B, then it has antigen, B antigen, then it has A antibody, that is, it has antibody against the A blood group. So what happens, they cannot take A blood, so that's why they can give blood to B, that is same group, and they can give blood to AB, and they can receive from B, that is same blood group, and receive from O, okay. And the next is AB, it has antigen AB, and it has no antibodies present in it, okay. It's like AB does not have any like security guard, that's how you remember it, okay. So what happens if there are no security guards, anyone can come in, right? So that's why it can receive blood from AB, O, all the blood groups. That's why AB is called as universal recipient, it can receive blood from any blood group, so that's why it is called as universal recipient, since it can receive blood from all the blood groups, okay. And it can give blood to only AB, okay, that's the thing, but it can receive blood from any all the blood groups. As for O, then it has no antigens present, okay, that's why it can be given to any blood group, okay, because it has no antigens in it. So let's say that you have the O blood group RBC, and it has no antigen present on it. So what happens, other blood group is there, okay, this O comes and contacts with this, since this have no antigens, so it won't be attacked by the antibodies of the other blood groups, because it has no antigen present in it, okay. I hope you understand. And it has antibodies for A and B, so it can take only the O blood group. Okay, the blood group O, it can take blood from only O, but it can be given to all the blood groups. That's why blood group O is called as universal donor. So this you have to remember. If in the examination, if they ask you which blood group is the universal donor, you have to say O blood group is the universal donor and AB is the universal recipient. Okay, this you have to remember, inshallah. Hope you all listened and understood well whatever I taught in this class, inshallah. Next class we will see about lymphatic system and other topics that come after this. Okay, barakallahu feekum. If you have any doubts, you can ask me, inshallah. I will clarify your doubts. Okay, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.